existed for many, many years in respect of the Silver Jubilee Bridge. And had we not built Maisie, Mersey Gateway, we would have still had to close Silver Jubilee Bridge, and there would have been no connection across the river for in excess of a year. Just imagine how that would have affected people's lives and would have affected business within the city region. So by looking forward as a city region, we've been able to address that, and we'll be able to close Silver Jubilee with a new bridge in place. It's a unique design. It's the only bridge of that design in the world, so it will add to the waterfront of the Liverpool City region. I hesitate to suggest it might be the fifth grace, but perhaps give me the opportunity to suggest that, please. The bridge itself is not it's part of a much bigger highway infrastructure project. I think it's the thing that people have heavily focused on, but those road networks, those almost 10 kilometres of road networks linking the M62 and the M56 are just as important. There's no point having a nice new bridge to cross if when you get to the end of it, you can't get to anywhere else. And unfortunately, and I think everybody would prefer to see an untolled bridge or untolled bridges, we had that argument with government, we lost that argument, and we're having to work with a tolled crossing. And I'll talk a little bit more about how we're trying to ease the pain of that for businesses and local residents. Worthwhile looking at a few numbers there, as always, these are big numbers. This is the largest project being delivered outside it's been delivered here in the Liverpool City region. I think we should be very proud of that. The other thing that's important, we're spending public money, and therefore we need to make sure that public money is spent well. And this particular project has very high value for money when you do all the technical calculations. And it will actually be zero cost for public purse over a 60-year period. Now, 60 years is a very long time, but we have to, this is a piece of infrastructure that will be there for well over 100 years, and therefore we need to look at the cost of it across that large number of years. It's very much of strategic importance. Yes, it brings great benefits to Halton and the residents of Halton, but the crucial importance to the city region and beyond, you can see there how it links across the estuary. The blue line right at the bottom there is the M56, and just to the north is the M62. That connectivity to the city region is absolutely fundamental, because at the moment that connectivity is coming in predominant to the M62, and we want to provide extra access and extra connectivity in the city region to give businesses the opportunity to thrive. It will also improve journey time reliability. How many people have been wondering whether, if I can get over Silver Jubilee Bridge, will I get my aeroplane from Liverpool John Lennon Airport? I think all of us have experienced that nervousness. What this is going to provide is the reliability of those journey times, as well as reducing journey times. And that's also important for businesses, because consistency of journey time is critical to businesses to deliver their businesses. What's also quite important is, as well as supporting the airport and the port, it is also going to improve air quality. There's been a lot of discussion about air quality, certainly in the city region. I know it's something that the Combined Authority and the Mayor are particularly keen to address. Well, Mersey Gateway is part of that journey in terms of improving air quality. There are local benefits. I mentioned these earlier. We want to improve cycling and walking. It would be really nice to stand on Silver Jubilee Bridge and enjoy the fabulous views over the estuary. That's a bit uncomfortable at the moment because of the way that the carriageway operates and the way we change the bridge to accommodate the 70-odd thousand vehicles that pass over every day. It's designed for 6,000. It takes 70,000 a day. So that shows you how hard working Silver Jubilee has been. But it's important, again, for the health of the city, region, and local community that we encourage cyclists and walking. And we have a more reliable service for the emergency services. And some of you may have seen last week we had an emergency services exercise on the bridge, which was quite scary to be really close to. And I'd like to take the opportunity to say well done to the emergency services, because they deal with that every single day of the week, and they just do it in a fantastic way and keep us all safe. But it's not just about building transport infrastructure. We've always described this as a bridge. really important because this is a bridge for prosperity. As I say, just building a bridge is not the answer. We want it to actually be something that delivers more. Something that it has delivered more, and this is quite a unique initiative. We established a time bank, and basically the companies who have contracted with us are providing support into local communities. So some of the local communities have had to suffer a lot of the congestion, have had things done for them to help them to improve their facilities. This one on here is a local school that had that playground done by Merseylink, the contractors, as part of them giving back to the community. I'm afraid that I have to talk about tolling because it is a toll crossing. And I introduce you to Merseyflow if you aren't already aware of Merseyflow. please, if you are going to use Mersey Gateway often, please register. Because if you do register, that will give you the opportunity to access some of the discount schemes that we've got. And there is a discount scheme for everybody. They are different depending on your circumstances. But if you register, you don't get advantage. If you don't register, you don't get advantage of those. If you do register, you can. Registration's open now. There's the website. It's a very simple website. Please use it because we want you to take advantage of those discounts. Just quickly, it's an AMPR process. Basically, that's number plate recognition. So unlike the tunnel tolls where you drop your money in the box or you use a fast tag, here you'll just drive your car over and it will take a picture of you. And if you've got a fast tag sticker, it will deduct the money from your account straight away. So it's as easy as this slide, really. Car comes along, drives across, gets its number plate taken. Lots of cameras, so don't try and get through without it because you will get caught. And we don't want to fine you, but if you don't pay, we will fine you because there'll be lots of people who are paying and they. You have to respect that that's the process. Time for completion. We will be opening this new facility within the next month. And I can virtually guarantee that it will be the next month. It should have been sooner, but some of you might have noticed we've had some